but in patches of clarity, they saw a teenage girl wearing a shirt with the stylized Friends logo from the TV show. The sequence showed a white man walking right up to the girl. "That's Riley and Reichert," Quinn said. The recording continued, but it was indistinct.
"We've never seen this stuff before," Lawton said. "It's working. We'll have to clean it up. That'll take time. But finally, we're on the right track."
"Good, good. Now we'll see what really happened," Quinn said.
71. San Diego, California. Blake's heart was beating faster. He'd never been to San Diego Police Headquarters, and now he was on the fourth floor, sitting in a sofa chair in a carpeted room lit with lamps. It was a soft interview room used mostly for assault victims or witnesses to convey that they were safe and hadn't done anything wrong. McDowell and Elson were in the two sofa chairs across from him. Blake took stock of the room, the vinyl bunched in the spot where his fingers gripped the arms of his chair. The detectives noticed.
"Did you find Riley?" Blake asked. "Why do you want to talk to me?"
"No, we still haven't located her," McDowell said. "But we need your help following up on some things. Are you comfortable?" Blake shrugged.
"We have to remind you that you're still under Miranda and our conversation is being recorded,"
Elson said.
"Are you arresting me or something? Do I need a lawyer?"
"You're not under arrest and you are not charged with anything," McDowell said. "We need to clarify a few things."
"Okay."
Blake licked his lips. A long moment passed with the detective staring at Blake until he grew uneasy, his eyes darting between them before Elson spoke.
"We understand that you gamble online."
Another silence passed, then Elson continued.
"And that you may have run up a significant debt."
Blake's eyes widened slightly, and his face whitened.
"And?"
Elson said.
"On the night of the party, you were seen with two people. One of them was looking under the RV, in the same area where our dog detected the presence of narcotics."
Blake's mouth opened slightly.
"We need the truth, Blake," McDowell said.
He was silent, staring but seeing nothing. Then tiny beads of sweat formed on his forehead.
"Blake, are you in any way involved in Riley's disappearance?"
McDowell asked. His shoulders dropped. The moment he'd dreaded had come, and his chin crumpled.
"Yes."
72. San Diego, California. McDowell leaned closer to Blake. She and Elson stared at him.
"You're involved in Riley's disappearance?"
Elson said. "I think I am."
"You think?"
Elson said.
"Where is she?"
"I don't know."
"Don't give us any BS. How are you involved?"
Elson said, his lips and chin trembling. Blake stared into space.
"When my mom and Courtney drowned, I couldn't deal with it. I was like, why them and not me, you know?"
His voice quavered.